person. At the outset, I would like to thank Professor Anuj Maheshwari, Professor Srinivas Murthy, Jayant Panda sir, and all the respected seniors in this podium for giving me opportunity to talk on such an important topic, bold from blue, Syncope, and how to approach. This is a vast topic. I'll try to cover it in next 15 to 20 minutes. My previous esteemed speaker, Pritam Gupta sir, has already covered some of the topic, orthostatic hypotension, tilt test and all. So, beating from KMC Manipal, where I come, what is bold from blue? If you see that, Greek god, Zeus, who was considered as a rain and thunder god, and that term was used by English sociologist, bold from blue, for a surprise. So, as their person told, Syncope is always surprising and bold from blue. My outline of talk, I will be talking on brief introduction, some of the causes and differential diagnosis and pathophysiology, and how to approach Syncope clinically. As sir told, that the theme is primary care. Syncope is diagnosed based on the history, simple investigation, ECG and clinical examination. Some diagnostic testing and management and summary. See this lady, all in a room. What is Syncope? It is defined as transient loss of consciousness due to, most important term is, cerebral hypoperfusion with inability to maintain postural tone that is followed by spontaneous recovery. There is no time. And syncope excludes seizures, vertigo, coma, shock, or other state of order. You see that there is a circle, there are so many times. Patient comes, I feel giddy, I feel dizzy. And in US, they say, I passed out, I fainted. So syncope is not a symptom. It's a symptom, not a diagnosis. Again, self-limited loss of consciousness, short duration, variable waning symptom, spontaneous and complete recovery. But complete loss of consciousness occurs within 20 seconds. So patient will be completely all right. What is the impact of syncope? If you see, 40% will experience syncope at one point of time. Common medical problems, 3% of emergency visits, and 1 to 6% of hospital admissions. Major mortality is the fall, which cause fractures, motor vehicle accidents, minor injuries. You see that there is a term called pre-syncope. When the patient feels initially feelings of giddiness, then there is a syncope is imminent, patient person sits, he will recover it. It's also called lightheadedness. If you see the differential diagnosis, syncope, there should be really, there should be transient loss of consciousness. Whereas syncope is can be neurally mediated, like vasovagal attack or neurocardiogenic, orthostatic hypotension, sir, Pritam sir has deliberated in detail. Cardiac arrhythmia, that's more serious cause of syncope. Structural heart disease, like aortic stenosis, or massive MI, or pulmonary embolism, cerebrovascular, non-syncopal, like psychogenic or pseudo-syncope, that there is a partial loss of consciousness. Most important differential diagnosis, seizure disorder, where there is a loss of consciousness, but usually for 5 to 10 minutes, but syncope, there is only transient loss of consciousness. So what there is a complete loss of consciousness without global hypoperfusion, hypoglycemia, hypoxemia, hyperventilation, hypercapnia, that's again psychogenic hyperventilation syndrome, drug overdose, vertebromacella, TAS. Disorders without impairment of consciousness, psychiatric illness like cataplexy, drop attacks, functional psychogenic, TAA of carotid origin. This is a major circle. What are the bases? Asserted hypotension related, either primary or secondary, reflex syncope, either vasodepressor, cardioinhibitory, or cardiac syncope, where there is obstruction or arrhythmia, or can be both. So if you see that by etiology, reflex, what is the most common cause? Situational cough syncope, Mukhyan syncope, carotid sinus hypersensitivity, the patient can, tight collar can cause, turning the neck can cause, atypical, which is a tilt positive, orthostatic hypotension has been dealt in detail, autonomic failure, either primary or secondary or drug-induced, cardiac arrhythmia, most important is heart blocks, tachycardia, particularly serious, particular tachycardia. tachycardia or drug-induced structural heat endocarditis, aortic stenosis, reactive lipsoma. If you see the mechanism-wise, bradyarrhythmia, tachyarrhythmia, no or slight rhythm of blood. This is hypotension. So evaluation, what is the etiology? Identify the etiology of syncope, then decide what is the risk factor. As I already told, either neurally mediated, or cardiac arrhythmia related, or structural heart disease, or cerebrovascular. So you have to decide whether the patient has lost consciousness, is it transient, or is it regular? If it is a prolonged loss of consciousness, is there hint of seizure? Is there a history of fall, coma, altered sudden cardiac death? Other things, non-traumatic, like most important, syncope is the vertebral attack, the differential rare. So classification, I already dealt it. Most important is neurally mediated, the vesovagal attack, post-ictation, drug-induced volume depletion, bradyarrhythmia, tachyarrhythmia like VT, rarely SVT. Another important is a long QT syndrome. And infarction, aortic stenosis, pulmonary embolism is one important cause. Aortic dissection is another important. Cerebrovascular syndrome and retrovascular insufficiency. Unexplained syncope can be 34% of cases. So if you see that most important is vasovagal attack. And if you see that if the person is younger, most important is either it's neurally mediated. If the person becomes older, cardiac and more serious causes become important. So episodes if you speak by causes, sudden attack occurring in a unpleasant environment, prolonged standing, it's a vasovagal attack, which we see commonly. Most common is long rounds in medical ward rounds or classes, or patient is taking a blood, that is one of the causes of syncope. This is cardiovascular reflexes, results in vasodilatation and bradycardia, fall in blood pressure and global cerebral hypoperfusion. This is what is called common heart shower, emotional stress, arthrostatic stress, and neurally mediated. This is a pathophysiology. I'm not going to detail. Most important is that decrease hypertension, low cardiac output, baroreceptor impairment, then lead to hypotension and cerebral hypoperfusion. There are three types: vasodilatory type, cardiac type, and vasodilatory type. There is a vasodilatation, hypotension, bradycardia. This is called there may be both parts like a vasodilatory and bradycardia. One more important part is a turning the neck, wearing a tight collar can lead to the deafferentiation of neck muscles, increased afferent signals that leads to syncope. This also again can be diagnosed based on the history. Orthostatic hypertension is dealt in detail, classical and initial. Sir has dealt in detail. I will not go in detail. Sudden fall of blood pressure more than 20 minutes within 3 minutes or immediately. If you see the important, how much loss of consciousness, either they call, either the bowel bladder implanted. Deaths can also occur in syncope, but if you deaths are typically vitals will be normal, vitals could have low bradycardia and hypotension. Initial evaluation, most important is history, 5P, prodermal symptoms, precipitation factor, palpitation, posture at what position the syncope occurs, post-event recovery. These are the things if you ask, you can make a diagnosis most of the time. Physical examination, BP, orthostatic hypotension, and also look at the cardiac examination, specifically aortic stenosis murmur, and also any other murmur, and neurological examination as well as to rule out seizure. Is it syncope or the data? Was there a loss of consciousness? Have a post. This all suggested is a syncope. Your question is whether the patient has a serious risk factor. Serious risk factor is decided as a cardiovascular, which can lead to sudden cardiac death. So, in syncope, during exertion or syncope, palpitation, prior history of sudden cardiac death in the family, non sustained pre existed coarse complex disease, prolonged QT interval, or QT pattern, then the severe anemia, hyperlactation. That is most important. Most important is Syncope score. Out of that, congestive heart failure, history of shortness of breath, hematocrit, less than 90 millimeters. If you see this, this is called test acronym. Look at the hematocrit less than 30%. ECG abnormalities in the form of bradycardia or tachycardia or blocks. Shortness of breath history is there. Systolic blood pressure is less than 90. This is common in all these things. So if you take then you can identify the what are the serious medical conditions. One is cardiac arrhythmia abnormalities, ventricle non-arrhythmic like ischemia, severe aortic stenosis. Non-cardiac condition you have to identify is sudden blood loss, anemia, major traumatic injury, persistent vital sign abnormality. How to evaluate the initially, as I have told, most important, then the patient evaluation is required, you can take it as a vesicular attack and leave it. If the initial evaluation is this is what the monitoring every day. Can record the ECG for 24 to 48 hours. This is a group record where the syncopal episodes are less common. You can use this fast test here. Hit head tilt test, whereas then in detail, table is tilted at 70 degrees with foot rest. There is no major contraindication, but indication is obvious repeated syncopal episode. In a single case of unexplained syncope, you should consider. And important to differentiate convulsive syncope and epilepsy. Complication, there is no contraindication. Left ventricular outgrowth or obstruction. I mean, for treatment, a simple measure, patient education, reassurance, and inspection, avoiding crowded environment, prolonged standing, adequate intake of fluid threshold, water intake, salt intake, field training, drug therapy. Not an ideal. So, associated injury, improved quality of life, education regarding avoiding triggering factors, recognition of head comes down, patient will improve. So, the most important thing is that making the patient prevent that maneuver to avoid the episode. So, evaluation and treatment may be required. Field training is another thing which can be done. Those who have got a recurrent attack of syncope. So, salt or volume, salt tablet, salt, midodrine, proxyprone, beta blocker, midodrine, all these things have been used. So, some of the complex challenging cases which I have seen, what if we have potential RPPP and the diagnosis of pulmonary embolism. So patient is now even afraid to stop the anticoagulation to decide to carry a cut. Second is a 35-year-old lady, repeated episode of syncope diplopia. She was brought to the hospital with a refractory hypotension. When she palpated the lower limb BP, pulse was well felt. It was a Takayasu syndrome with dented and palpated. Very simple, it was a complete heart attack. Walking to the people, we found the keys together. It was a fever induced disorder, but we wanted electrocardiogram. He was not feeling. And they repeated it before the diagnosis of this aspect. And the patient was the and the patient was the same. So, coming to summary and conclusion, all of you agree. syncope is a very common medical problem. Most important, like a primary case, taking a good history, what position it occurred, how many positions, previous history, premonitory symptoms, was there any palpitation, what was the post recovery, clinical examination. Most important is pulse, blood pressure, cardiac auscultation, neurological examination, judicious investigation, simple to investigate, hemoglobin, hematocrit, ECG, glucose, electrolytes, and also if required further, EEG may be helpful. Most important is syncope, always close differential. We always ask the patient, is it syncope or is it seizure? Because both of them are very common. Just saffron can identify high patient who got a cardiac disease or further evaluation needs to be evaluated. Evaluation is syncope, valid in clinical practice, but in primary care, most important is only history and examination. Thank you for the patient figuring. These are my references. So I want to end with William Master's quote. Medicine is a science of uncertainty, the art of probability. So we know that syncope is a disease, vast number of differentiators, vast number of, it's not a diagnosis. You have to find out the cause. Thank you for the patient listening.